But now to a story that will truly warm your heart as we take you on a journey from silence to the sound of laughter and joy.
Tonight we begin a three-part series as we introduce you to a local boy who's been unable to hear since birth. But this week, doctors are giving him the chance to hear for the first time in his life.
6-year-old Mason Drake has an infectious laugh and a smile that lights up the room.
He is the happiest kid. He just, he's happy to just be around people. He loves to people watch.
But amid the laughter, this is how Mason experiences the world. Without any sound.
He just wants to be doing what everybody else is doing, you know, to the best of his ability.
We first met Mason at one of his favorite places, Kids Club in Phoenix, a place where kids can be kids, where there are no limitations. And in so many ways, he's just like any other kid, squealing with joy as he spins around with his dad. But the way he takes in the rest of us is in silence.
He doesn't really cry if he gets hurt or anything. The only time he cries is when his feelings are hurt. If he feels like he's left out, if kids are doing something he can't do, as you can see, he's trying to see what everybody else is doing right now.
When his mother, Jessica, was pregnant, she found out at her 20-week sonogram something was wrong. After Mason was born, she learned he had a rare condition called pachygyra, a brain malformation that left him deaf and unable to speak or walk on his own.
He failed the newborn hearing screenings in the hospital, and so we had to keep bringing him back, and he kept failing.
As he got older, Mason didn't progress typically. He had significant motor delays.
Mason down.
And now uses sign language.
Who's dad?
To communicate with his mom and dad.
Sign, train.
With his circumstances and, you know, with what we've been through with him, you know, you're always thinking ahead. You know, you want to know, you know, where is he going to be, you know, 3 years from now, a year from now.
And it's all about to change for this little guy. Doctors are implanting bilateral cochlear implants, allowing him to hear for the first time in his life.
I can't believe it's real, because we were told no for so long, that it wasn't a possibility, it wouldn't work. We'd had a bunch of tests, and we just kind of kept hitting a dead end.
But last year, a neurologist in Rochester told them it was not only possible to try, but would actually work. Just weeks from now, doctors will turn on the device, giving Mason the remarkable chance to hear, turning a life lived in silence into a whole new world with the sounds of other children playing, the voices of his parents.
Hang on, buddy. I'm gonna pick these after.
And even hearing his own laugh for the first time. A gift most of us take for granted. One his mom and dad have only dreamed of for their little boy.
I really just want him to hear our voice, you know, to hear and to understand what he's been missing out on.
And I would love for him to be able to hear me, you know, for him to just hear the, you know, simple words as I love you or it's daddy, and you know, he's my little guy, my little boy.
Life is changing in a big way for Mason.
Yeah, I think Kevin and Jessica, though, already understand that Mason does hear them in every other way.
Certainly.
With the exception of being able to use those ears.
Well, tomorrow night, we are giving you incredible access as we take you inside the operating room as Mason is given the gift of sound. And we'll be with him as doctors turn on the implants, allowing Mason to hear for the very first time.
How special to share this with the family. Really nice stuff.
Yeah, you won't want to miss it.
Here's what's happening across New York tonight.
The state is